1968. How about a big welcome for the one and only Mambo?
Yeah, Mambo!
Hello there, folks. Here we go. Cab driver, drive by Mary's plane. I just want a chance to see her face. Don't stop the meter, let it race. Cab driver, drive by Mary's plane. Cab driver, once more round the block. Never mind the ticking of the clock. I only wish we could have had that talk. Cab driver, once more round the block. Cab driver, once more down the street. There's this fancy place we used to eat. That's where my life, my future and figure. Cab driver, once more down the street. Cab driver, perhaps I'll hold her in my arms once more. Then things would be just like they were before. Cab driver, wait here by the door. Cab driver,
Mambo. You know, my wife woke me one morning. She was feeling completely deflated. My word, I feel like my mind is almost completely gone, she said. Are you really surprised, I asked. She said, why would you say that, Dale? It's because you've been giving me a piece of it for 55 years. Be in trouble again. I can't stand prosperity. Babyface was a very popular song in its day. It was written and published in 1926 by Harry X, with lyrics by Benny Davis. That same year, Jan Garber had a number one hit. And please welcome our Paradiso ladies, Nina, Esther, Arlene, and Melissa.
Yeah.
favorite pastimes out here since relocating is fishing. How many fishermen we got out there? Oh, several. Yeah, I was up at Lake Pleasant fishing last week, fishing for bass. And I was having no luck whatsoever, nothing. I kept casting and casting, and after a half hour, I was at boat and felt something wrapping around my leg, and I looked down, there was a doggone snake crawling up the leg. Had a snake in its, or a frog in its mouth. I said, oh, what am I going to do now? You know, I could use that frog for bait. I want that frog in a bad way. So I reached down, grabbed that snake behind the back of the head, pulled that frog out of its mouth. I thought, now how do I get rid of this frog or the snake without getting bit? So I put the frog down. I grabbed my bottle of Jack Daniels, poured it right straight down that frog's mouth and that snake, or that snake's mouth, and he just went. Sure enough, that'll do it. Threw him right back in the lake. Took that frog, put him on that hook, and I'm just casting away and casting away. Nothing. Nothing. All of a sudden, I feel something on my leg again. I look down, it's that dadgum snake, and he's got two frogs in his mouth. Crazy. How many of you remember the days of radio shows? Armis Brooks, one of them. Yeah, you betcha. I'd sit there and listen and think and dream. Before TV, families would gather around a radio to hear the latest installment of their favorite comedy, drama, or soap opera. Tonight, we will introduce you to The Quibbles, as played by Bob and Pam Schultz, Vern Oddie, and Fred Wilson.
Now for another fun-filled visit with everyone's favorite couple, Clinton and Carol Quibble. The Quibbles are brought to you by a pan of toothpaste. A pan of a toothpaste that puts a shine in your smile. As the scene opens, we find Carol and Quinton just finishing their breakfast.
Quinton, I can't see you. Are you chewing with your mouth open again?
Yeah.
Quinton, why do you always read the newspaper while we eat?
So you can't see me chew with my mouth open.
But then we can't see each other.
That's right, Carol.
You have the paper awfully close to your face. Maybe you need reading glasses. Well?
I can see just fine, Carol.
Come in. Good morning.
Oh, good Lord.
Hi, Matt. Want some coffee? No, thanks. I really don't have the time. I just dropped by to ask if you'd seen Harold and Elaine James in the last couple of days. No, why, Matt? Well, now I'm not one to spread gossip. But I know I saw Sally Tisdale at the Garden Club banquet last evening, and she told me that Ruth Miner told her, that Jenna Scully told her when they were at the pool exercise class, that Harold James was seen last week walking down Main Street with a very pretty, young, tall redhead in broad daylight. What do you think of that?
Well, I never.
Lois Turnby also saw them, and so did Gloria Whitcomb.
Her name is Robin, and she's Harold's sister. She was in town to visit Harold and Elaine on a trip to go see their mother.
Oh, that must be why no one has seen them lately.
That's probably the reason, Madge.
Oh my, look at the time. I have to run. I have to do some shopping before I take my books back to the library. By the way, have you noticed Susan, the librarian, looking peaked lately? I hope she's not expecting again. Her poor husband worked so hard to support the family as it is, and...
Sorry to see you leave so soon, Madge.
Oh, yes, well, I'll see you later then.
Bye, Madge. Drop in anytime.
What are you doing, Quinton?
I'm locking the door.
Quinton, the house is dirty.
Yes?
Why did you say yes?
I was being agreeable.
Then you don't think I keep a clean house?
Yes, no, yes, oh good Lord.
I think think it would be fun if we cleaned the house together. What do you think?
Fun?
Yes. Well?
Well, what?
Shall we? Shall we clean the house together?
Okay.
When?
About next year.
I was thinking today would be good.
Yes, I was thinking about today too. I was thinking it would be a good day to play golf.
Quentin, if you loved me, you would help me clean the house.
Let's clean house. I'll get the vacuum and you get the dust mop.
I thought I'd get the vacuum.
Okay, I'll get the mop.
If you'd rather use the vacuum.
No, I love the mop.
But the vacuum's too heavy for me.
Fine, I'll use the vacuum.
Before we find out who's going to have the joy of using the vacuum, I'd like to remind you what a joy it is to use a can of toothpaste. Film star Lana Turner is quoted as saying, "I use it just before going on set, and my teeth shine throughout the scene." My director is so happy, he encourages all his actors to brush with Ipana. Yes, folks, it cleans Miss Turner's teeth, and her mouth stays fresh all day. He can do the same for you. Now let's return to Carol and Quentin, who are busy cleaning the living room.
Quentin, you missed some dust in the corner there. I don't think you see the dirt. I think you need new glasses. Maybe you should have your eyes examined. Well?
Well, what?
Are you going to have your eyes examined?
Right now I'm cleaning house, Carol.
Why are you rubbing your hip that way? Does it hurt?
No, it's just tired from bending.
I've noticed you've been rubbing it lately. Maybe you should see a hip doctor.
I'm fine, Carol.
Quentin, you missed a cobweb in the ceiling.
Carol, you can't get a cobweb off the ceiling with a vacuum. Besides, I don't see it.
I told you you need new glasses.
I'm going golfing.
How can you hit that little ball with your club if you can't see it?
I'll kick it.
The Quibble family is brought to you by a pan of toothpaste. The film stars love it, and you will too. Be sure to tune in next time when we'll hear Carol say,
"Quentin, I've got a surprise for you."
This is your announcer reminding you to use Ipana every day, and smile is good for you.
Super Bowl last month there was, but this guy gets a free ticket, but finds out when he gets there it's in the nosebleed section, way up there. But he looks down, he sees an empty seat on about the 50-yard line, only about four rows up. So he runs down there and parks himself right in that seat. Turns and says, "What a view," he says to the elderly lady next to him. "Why would anybody pass this up?" "It's my husband," she said. "We've gone to every Super Bowl since we were married. But he passed away. I'm so sorry. But couldn't you find a friend to come with you?" She shook her head and said, "No, they're all at the funeral." And now, folks, we are pleased to present our fabulous jazz band with their rendition of Bill Bailey. Take it away, boys.
Thank you. honey, I'll even pay the rent. I know that I've done you oh so wrong. You remember that rainy egg I threw you out with nothing but a fine tooth comb. I know I'm to blame now. Ain't that a shame? It'll make you, won't you please come
I know what's on
You know, I've been thinking about how I want to leave this earth. And I'm getting at that age where it puts a lot of energy in my mind. And I kind of decided I want to go like my grandfather died, in his sleep. Not screaming in terror like the rest of the people in his car. All right. Are you ready for the next installment of the Quibblers? I think I am. Let's give them a nice welcome back. The Quibblers.
Discusses whether or not to take tap dancing lessons.
I think taking tap dancing lessons would do you a lot of good. It would cheer you up.
I'm cheerful enough, Carol.
I heard that Cary Grant takes tap lessons.
That's certainly motivation.
Well, just the fact that you're sitting there with no energy means something.
Yes, Carol, it means I'm starving. If I promise to take tap lessons, can I have a sandwich?
Oh, yes, Quentin, and I know you won't be sorry. Now, who could that be?
Why don't you answer and find out?
Oh, that's a good idea. Hello. Yes, it is. Oh, goodness. What a disappointment. Well, I guess so. Yes, goodbye.
Who is that?
The dance studio. They only have room for one more in the tap lessons. They said they'd put my name in, but there's no room for you. Oh, but I feel terrible. What on earth are you going to do all those Saturday afternoons when I'm gone?
Oh, I'll think of something, Carol. Don't worry about me.
Oh, but I do. How about calling a friend? Maybe you could do something with Fred or Stanley.
Maybe, Carol, but they'd be playing golf.
Maybe they let you join them.
I suppose I could ask.
Oh, Quentin, you're such a good sport. Here's a nice big ham sandwich, and I have no idea. I have an idea. I'll call and ask if they have evening dance lessons.
What a swell idea.
That's our show for this time, folks. Tune in again next time and hear Carol say,
Quentin, why don't you ever wear the sweater my mother knit for you?
This is your announcer reminding you to make a date with glamour. Shampoo your hair with Halo every day and keep it lustrous and lovable. Halo shampoo is endorsed by Good Housekeeping and keep smiling. It's good for you.
You know, I had a real funny experience this week already. I'm going down Thunderbird, just past the hospital over there, Vanderbilt Hospital. Stopped at a light, and this ambulance turned the corner right in front of me. And just as they did, the back door swung open, and out came a cooler, landed on the pavement. And they kept on going. Oh, boy. So I stopped, got out of the car, and went over and picked up the cooler, opened it up, looked inside, and somebody's big toe back in ice. Oh, gross. I thought about that for a minute, and then I called a tow truck right away. They stick with me, it gets worse. Our next song has remained very popular ever since it was first recorded by Nat King Cole in 1951. His daughter, Natalie Cole, later recorded it as a duet using tapes of her father's original. Written by Irving Gordon, it was first titled Uncomparable. But the publishing company asked Gordon to change it to Unforgettable. Here is our newest crooner, Paul Johnson, to perform it for us.
Unforgettable.
6 weeks vacation, 14 paid holidays a year, full medical and dental, company